Boom! On Thundercloud. Good morning this morning, It would have to be one of the finest mornings if ever there was such a morning. And if tomorrow morning is fine as this morning, then tomorrow morning will be the finest morning if ever there was such a morning. Good morning. I'm Thundercloud and I'm here at Bluff Rock just outside of Tanterfield on the top of the New England Plateau. Just up at Bluff Rock was where Captain Thunderbolt camped once and cooked up a bit of mutton, hid out. Today, I've got one of my ebooks is online for free from the 17th of March 2020 through to the, the 21st of March through to the 25th. So you can go onto Kindle and you can download my latest release there, book two of Love and Lust in Limbin, Lust in Nimbin. I'm going to read to you from it today. This is something that I wrote, pretty much 3 years ago, and it's from there. It's called Stolen Wealth Australia. I suppose it's kind of appropriate since I'm in Thunderbolt's country, in one of the areas where there was such big genocides against the indigenous people here. Let's go. If a cow jumps a fence, does it want to be free? Does a chief executive officer execute people? And what does a president preside over, and who in which ministry is the prime minister? Does the treasurer treasure life or something else? And why does the speaker of the house really have an opinion? Is a Lord Mayor God? I don't know. Is the premier really the number one for morals and compassion? And if people are peaceful, who do police police? And why do police police police? If police police police, why are police rarely charged and prosecuted for crimes? Are police more moral than non-police? I don't know. Why await white Australian invaders xenophobic about non-white, non-Christian people coming to live in Australia? If the Commonwealth isn't benefiting all the common, wouldn't it be stolen wealth? Isn't it time to give back all the stolen wealth from the land that was taken from the original people by the invading settlers? Maybe we could at least rename some of the cities. How can Australia be decolonised and real democracy and rights brought to the people? Well, that's stolen off Australia. Hey, what about surface paradise? Here we go. Grateful for camphor laurel, the feral cane toads too, the early morning hollows from a pack of cockatoos. Couldn't count my blessings, I'd run right out of time. Grateful for the words I know I've written down in rhyme. Salty water, battery hands, the system is a failure. What an opportunity, let's decolonize Australia. Well, here I am, my fire's just about out. I'm going down to Gyra to open the Australian Poetry Hall of Fame. What a journey that's going to be. Magnificent. Glorious. Yeah. As a lovely young lady I met last night kept saying, glorious. And I thought, what a lovely thing to say. All right. Well, it's a glorious day. I'm going to take you out and I'll show you about what it looks like out here. Okay. So over there. There we go. Bluff Rock in the sun. We zoom on in. There goes a truck. And that way up there is where Captain Thunderbolt hung out. Yeah. Long ago. And just if we come over here, there's a bit more information I'd like to share with you. That's where the sun's coming up today. That's where I camped last night. Yeah, if we come over here, just so you know where we are. bluff rock that's all been cut up and sectioned and put lines all over the map, but the first inhabitants here were the Ngarrabal people. So this is the Goombridge Swamp. I'd say that was the original name, Goombridge Swamp, unless that was sort of like a name of the settlers, probably. But it was reported that in 1868, Thunderbolt camped the night here, and his meal was freshly cooked mutton. Wow. All right. Well, I'm Thundercloud, washing away the garbage, leaving behind the rainbows after rain. I'm on my way to Gyra to create the Australian Poetry Hall of Fame. Yeah. Well, I don't need to be pretentious and talk like a twit, and I can put on my Aussie accent, mate. Yeah. And I'd just do it. All right, it's time to go. Look, you can look in a tree, and I'll push this button, and I'll see you later, see? Boom.